Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is Cooking with Your Comadre, and we are making comfort foods today. Today we're making one of my favorite comfort foods. This is chicken tortilla soup on the border style. So if you've ever been to one of my favorite restaurants on the border, they are known for their famous tortilla soup, and it is one of my favorite reasons to visit this restaurant. Like, I remember just being sick and not feeling good, and in college just going and getting a big bowl of the on the border tortilla soup, and I just felt so much better. So today I am going to show you how to make your very own at home. You're gonna need a few ingredients. First, you'll need a bag of the on the border cafe style chips. You'll need a big bag of Mexican blend cheese. I picked up some at my local HEB. You'll wanna pick up a rotisserie chicken, which I have already deboned. So you'll definitely wanna do that. You can also make some chicken at home. I do not recommend doing the canned chicken. The rotisserie has always worked well for me. It's fresh, grab it from your local deli in your grocery store. I picked mine up at HEB. This next thing you're gonna need is some chicken broth, and probably a 32 ounce should be good. You can do a larger size depending on what size bowl you're going to be making, or what size pot you're going to be making. Then, of course, the special ingredient is the on the border salsa. Now, I'm gonna be making mine with mild today because my daughter, she really enjoys this soup. So I wanna make sure that she's able to enjoy it. But if you prefer, they also carry a hot salsa, which this is probably what my husband would prefer if he was the only one eating the pot, which believe me, he usually can eat a pot by himself. Also, you're gonna want some avocados, and we're gonna use those later. They're going to be to top off the soup with your shredded cheese. So to begin, I've got my pot going. I have already started boiling my chicken broth. So I poured all my chicken broth in. And the next part is really simple. You're just gonna take your on the border salsa and you're gonna pour it in to the chicken broth. Now I'm adding my on the border salsa into my chicken broth, which has already been boiling for probably about 5 minutes. All right. I'm gonna get all that in there. And see, the great thing about this is that it already has everything. It has your onions, it has your tomato, jalapenos, garlic, and all your spices. So it really doesn't require much on your behalf, okay? So you wanna get that going. Stir it really good. And then you'll go ahead and you'll bring that to a boil. All right, next over here, I'm gonna go ahead and saute your squash, your zucchini. I have yellow and green. You can also add carrots to this mixture. You can saute some onions. You wanna just make sure that your veggies are nice and soft, because we're gonna be adding this into the soup. This is what makes this soup so delicious and so special and so colorful. The more veggies you add, the better. Now, and on the border, they always have their zucchini squash. They have onions in the soup, and occasionally I think I've seen a carrot or two, but today I'm not adding carrots. I'm just gonna add my zucchinis. So, next what you wanna do, you wanna go ahead and take your squash, and we're gonna go ahead and just add it into our soup. And we're gonna go ahead and mix. All right, next, Now, like I mentioned before, I had purchased a rotisserie chicken and I have already pulled it apart. And you can cut it down as much as you want. The most important part is just making sure that you debone it. And you can use the chicken breast. You can use all parts of the chicken. Just make sure you get all the bones out. Like, I just felt a little bone here, so I definitely want to pull that out. Pull the skin off. You don't want any skin. Okay. Just kind of feeling around for bones and that kind of thing. Once I've completely removed all that, I'm going to go ahead and add this into my soup. And then I'm going to go ahead and stir that around as well. Now, something else you can be doing on the side, and this isn't something I'm going to be doing today, but if you have a little rice cooker or if you want to just in a little pan make some rice, it can be just white rice or Mexican rice, your choice. You can make some on the side and it tastes really good to put at the bottom. Now, they do have rice in their recipe, but you only taste a little bit when you're eating at the restaurant. Like, they're just scooping. When you scoop it out of your bowl, you only taste like a little bit of rice. And the soup itself is very filling. So if you add rice, I'm telling you, it's gonna absorb a lot of the soup and absorb a lot of the flavor. Cause I've done it before. If you add too much rice, it can kind of kill the soup. So you don't wanna do that. But adding just a little bit into the bowl just gives it that little extra oomph, and it tastes really delicious. All right, so we're gonna wait on this to cook, and then once it's done, I will be back to show you how to prepare your bowl. All right, so we're back. So we wanted to make our soup, bring it to a boil, and then you wanted to go ahead and let it simmer for about 20 minutes. So it's at a boil now. It's at a really good boil. While I'm doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and make my rice, and I'm just using it a little rice maker right over here. So I did a cup of rice and 2 cups of water, and I'm just putting in my little rice maker, and once it's done, it'll pop up on its own. So my husband decided that he does want some rice in his soup. So we're gonna put that at the bottom and I'll show you how to prepare that once we are done. So at this point, I let mine simmer for about 30 minutes. So the chicken has absorbed a lot of the flavor. All your veggies are nice and soft. Your soup is done. So now I'm gonna show you how to prepare your bowl. So over here, I've already sliced up some avocado. Here, we're gonna take a bowl. I've already put some of our on the border chips at the bottom. The next thing you wanna do is go ahead and just start scooping some soup into your bowl. Plenty of veggies, plenty of chicken. You get yourself some of that soup in there. That broth is delicious. I was gonna mention as well, like, if this is something that you want to prepare before you, maybe you go to church or before the kids have like soccer practice, or you have something going on, maybe you have an appointment and you want to have a meal by the time you come home, you can prepare all this the night before. Cut up your veggies, saute them, and have them ready to go. Cut up your chicken the night prior, and then all you have to do is stick it in a crock pot, put it on slow cook, and you can just have it cooking while you are out and about doing your thing. So we've put our soup, and then now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna add a little bit of rice. Remember, I told you that I was making this separately in my rice cooker. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of rice and go ahead and put some of that in there. A little have it in rice. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and grab myself some avocado. I'm gonna put it right on top. Couple of sauces there. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add some cheese. Now this is delicious. This is like my daughter's favorite part. I'm gonna put the flame down super quick. Okay, here we go. So you take yourself some cheese, just kind of sprinkle it on. You can put a little bit or a lot, however you want. And there you go. There is your on the border style tortilla soup. Now you can just enjoy, and you can enjoy this with tortillas, or you can enjoy with more on the border cafe style chips. I hope you enjoy.